Hi, I'm David Wilde here with, as if I had to say, Barry Manilow. And we're talking about his great new album, 15 Minutes. We want to talk about a song that is really about both sides of the fame equation, the observer and the observed. Can you tell me a little bit about Letter from a Fan, So Heavy, So High?
Well, it's two songs there. And Letter from a Fan, and I'll tell you something, that was the one that I was the most wary about. I didn't think that my audience would be able to handle this. And I was pleasantly surprised that this is maybe the most popular song on this album. I think it's because it is so interesting. I don't think I've ever written a song like this, and I know I've never recorded a song like this. Like I say, there's two songs. One, Letter from a Fan, is from a very innocent fan, and I asked a girl named Natalie Dawn, who is the lead singer of a group named Pomplamoose, who's very, very popular on YouTube and the internet, to do the lead on it. She did it great. And then I come in as the guy that's in the middle of all of this, and he's just had it. He's at the top of his fame, and he doesn't like it, and this letter pushes him over. He's a million hotel rooms. Nobody will leave him alone, and then he gets this letter, he's had it. But the energy of this song is more than any kind of album I've ever made, and her part is kind of interesting and gets a little creepy.
Yeah, no, you have to go back to like Billie Jean to have that kind of that tale of obsession, or Eminem has a song that does this. It's sort
Somebody
of
else
that,
that
idea
that.
Of obsession and the obsessed and the you know the one that creates the obsession.
Well, in the beginning, I don't think you know that where the song is going. Do you?
No, no.
When the first time you heard it, you didn't think that it was going where it's about to go, right?
Not at all. But I liked where it went.
Yeah, I mean, I wrote this little melody, which I thought she was just writing now. She's just humming while she's writing to him.
Remember I sent you a picture. I know all the names in your band. I was the girl wearing yellow down front. I was the first one to stand. It's silly to think you'd remember. Silly pretending you'd care, but I want you to know I was there last night. I was there, I was there, I was there, I was there,
I was there. Well, it already sounds a little creepy, doesn't it?
I mean, haunted,
you don't know where
yeah.
she's going here, but it does get, you know, and I think all of us have had fans who have gone a little too far. I know I have, and I'm sure many of us have had people who have gone too far. And I did have this, by the way. This is based on a real, Nick and I were in the same room when this happened. And I'm not gonna go into the whole story, but it was terrifying. And all I know is that when this happened, I had a security guard named Shlomo following me around for a month after that.
That's not intimidating.
Another room where the lights are too bright. Not gonna sleep, I want it just right. The million hotel room, random replay. There's too many touching me. Keep them away. Move into midnight, just turn off the pager. And tell you the well has run dry. Too tired to sleep, too wired to try. Fast track to nowhere.
So he's stoned, he's in a hotel room, and he's so screwed up by this time. I mean, can fame do that to somebody? I mean, you've seen it more than I have.
Well, no, I have to say, what I love about this record is, it reminded me, because I think of you as someone, you became accidentally very famous, in that I think you got in here into this business to make music. You're a music guy.
I did.
But I worry about, this album reflects the world today, because I think there's a new generation for whom, in the age of reality TV, fame goes first. Mm-hmm. First, what people want is to be famous.
I actually heard people say they want to be famous.
And as a goal.
As a goal.
Right.
That makes me a little nervous.
And this album, to me, is a great expression of that kind of disease that gets into our culture sometimes.
Mm. And this is the climax. I think it's the climax, and I actually put some really heavy guitar work in it. This song lasted about 3 more minutes originally because I had a lot of guitar work on this thing, and I thought, well, I'm just overdoing it. It was wonderful, wonderful rock and roll guitar work, and we just said, okay, it's enough. I'm asking the audience to sit through something that I don't think they could. But, you know, there's some really great stuff already on here, but it lasted for 2-3 more minutes of guitar. This.
Great playing throughout.
Great playing. There must have been 2 more minutes of craziness, because I wanted him to go crazy. And here she comes again.
Never wave back at the airport. I covered your poster in mud. I cut out the eyes on the photo you sent.
There's something very powerful about the fact that this is like, this kind of fan would imagine a duet with their dream artist, and in a way the song gives them that.
Uh-huh.
So it's very sort of...
Oh, well, it is kind of a duet, isn't
yeah.
it? Only she's way over there and he's way over there. It's all
both
in
a little
there,
screwed yes. up.
Well, check it out. It's one of the most interesting songs on the album, I think. It's called 15 Minutes, and see what you think. Here's the album cover. Okay? Bye.